Nanner's dinner is served. Think I have a master that's changed places with his dog. Out of remorse, Liza.
If you would be so good, Liza.
How was your day, dear?
See my punishment living in the kennel.
I'm sorry, dear one.
No, it is I who should be sorry. Always I. Never you, Mary dear. But now I feel drowsy. Won't you play me to sleep on the nursery piano? And shut the window, Mary dear. I feel a draught.
George, never ask me to do that. The window must always remain open for them. Always. Always.
Yes.
Quick, Tinker! Close the window! Bar it! Then when Wendy comes back, she'll think her mother is barred around and she'll have to come back to me. Now, Tinker, you and I must go out by the door. Wendy's mother. She's a pretty lady, but not so pretty as my mother. She's making the box say, "Come home, Wendy." We'll never see Wendy again, lady, for the window is barred.
Come on.
Wendy. Oh, Wendy.
There are two wet things sitting on her eyes. As soon as they go, another two come and sit on her eyes. Come on, Tink. We don't need any silly mothers.
Oh, I think I've been here before. I nearly forgot.
I saved the kennel.
That's Nana, isn't it?
There's a man asleep in it.
It's Father.
Oh, let me see Father. Oh, he's not as big as the pirate I killed.
It's awfully careless of Mother not to be here when we came back.
That is her play.
Who is that lady?
Shh! It's Mother. So you're not really our mother then, Wendy?
Oh dear, I think it's quite time to be back.
Let us creep in and put our hands over her eyes.
No, let us break it to her gently. So often in my dreams, but I seem still to see them when I'm awake. I'll not look again. So often their silver voices call to me, my little children. You'll not see no more. Mother, and that is Wendy.
Mother.
And now it is John.
Mother.
And now Michael. And when they call to me, I stretch out my arms to them, but they never come. They never come. Wendy! What's the matter? One, two, they all have mothers except me. Is your name Slightly? Yes. Then I'm your mother. How do you know? I feel it in my bones.
Hello, Wendy.
say anything to my parents, Peter?
No.
About a very sweet subject?
No. No, Wendy.
About me, Peter?
No.
Peter, let me adopt you too.
Would you send me to school?
Yes.
And then to an office?
I suppose so.
Soon I should be a man.
Very soon.
Well, don't want to go to school and learn solemn things. No one is going to catch me, lady, and make me a man. I want always to be a little boy and to have fun.
But where are you to live, Peter?
I'll live in the house we built for Wendy. The fairies had to put it high up in the treetops.
To think of it. But I thought all the fairies were dead.
No, indeed.
You'll be very lonely in the evenings, Peter.
I shall have Tink.
Oh, Mother, may I go?
Certainly not. I've just got you home again, and I mean to keep you.
But he does so need a mother.
So do you, dear one. But, Peter, I shall let her go to you once a year, for a week, to do your spring cleaning. Now, say goodnight, Wendy.
Oh, couldn't I go down just for a minute?
Goodnight, Peter.
Night, Wendy.
You won't forget me, will you?
Before spring cleaning time comes,
some people that we'd like to bring up. Ben, if he would be so kind, come. He won't make you look.